How are we looking for winter sports? Has there been any discussion as to what's going to be played and what's not? Any news for us?
So the big news was that last Friday, the state released their updated guidelines through the EEA, which is the Executive Office of Energy and Environmental Affairs. That's the government body that's really been regulating sports since this pandemic began. And I have to say, you know, personally, you know, people are always going to feel one way or the other. You're going to have people who are really happy. You're going to have people that are very, very frustrated. For me, I was pleasantly surprised. You know, we had a lot of modifications with our fall sports. Anyone that's watched our soccer and field hockey contests, even cross country, we had to make significant modifications, and that's considered a low risk sport. So I really didn't know what to expect. Now that we're kind of moving inside, we have some high risk sports as well as moderate risk sports. So I was pleasantly surprised by those guidelines that sort of set the stage for us to have a pretty full winter season. There's still some steps that need to be taken, but I'm certainly hopeful that we're going to have a pretty, you know, pretty robust winter season, you know, for the Hillers.
Now, we do know there'll be no postseason tournaments. There'll be no tournaments in general. So let's start off with basketball, I guess. They're using the athletic center currently as classroom space to socially distance the students. So that could that create any problems in regards to basketball being played?
So no, it's a great question. We're going to be able to play basketball, assuming, again, we get the full go ahead to play basketball, which I expect that we will. You know, just so that the viewers and everyone knows, we won't know definitively until I believe it's November 20th. That's when the MIAA Board of Directors will really put out their final say on the winter season. And whether or not any sports get moved to another season, what the final modifications may be, things of that nature. Right now, all the sport committees are meeting in subcommittees to come up with what might need to be done in order to meet the guidelines. And then they'll present to the Sports Medicine Committee on Monday and Tuesday of next week. So there could be a little back and forth. You know, if the initial presentation, you know, goes before sports medicine and they say, well, no, this isn't quite enough, we need a little bit more. So there could be some back and forth before it ultimately gets to the board of directors. But basketball, again, I am pretty optimistic that we'll be able to have it. The biggest challenge for us will be more managing practice times. You know, we're hoping to run all 8 levels of basketball, including the middle school teams. We will not have access to some of the gyms that we normally do around the district because the gyms are being used for other purposes due to the circumstances. The high school, as you mentioned, Tom, most of the really all the desks actually are around the track. So that's going to create an issue in that sense. But the court itself will actually be cleared of all the storage that's currently on there. Thanks to our facilities guys who have already done an amazing job all year long. And now they're kind of getting some more curveballs thrown at them as we ask them to clear out some of this storage so that we can play our winter sports.